Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'd. I welcome you to this very first session of our series that we will be conducting throughout this month of Ramadan, where we will be taking each juz or para of the Qur'an and going through it within just a few minutes every single day, bi-ithnillah. And the point of this is not really to have an extensive explanation of each part of the Qur'an, nor a tafsir, but rather to simply derive some lessons and to give some reminders concerning these various parts of the Qur'an. Obviously, the time will not suffice us to go into detail, covering each and every single verse, but rather we will just take the main themes that were discussed in each and every single part of the Qur'an. We start today with the very first para or juz of the Qur'an, which starts with the opening of the Qur'an, which is Surah Al-Fatiha. And so Surah Al-Fatiha, which translates to the opening, is the first surah of the Qur'an, and it is one of the most important surahs of the Qur'an, which we are required to recite in our salah, showing the importance of it. In fact, a person's salah is invalid if he does not recite the surah and if he does not recite it properly. Surah Al-Fatiha basically is a dua. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala firstly praising himself. He starts by praising himself. Then he mentions how, worship is solely for the sake of Allah alone. And then Allah tells us about guidance, the way of guidance. And so we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the straight path and not the misguided path. After that, we have Surah Al-Baqarah. And Surah Al-Baqarah extends over three ajza' or paras of the Qur'an. And in this first juz or para of the Qur'an, Surah Al-Baqarah starts with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us of the revelation of the Qur'an and how this book that Allah has revealed, it is from Allah. And then Allah tells us of three categories of people: the mu'minun, the believers; the kuffar, the disbelievers; and the munafiqun, or the hypocrites. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a few characteristics of the hypocrites, because they are the most dangerous of people to the believers. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us a little bit about who the hypocrites are and what are their traits, what are their characteristics, so that we beware of them in each and every single era. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically tells us of the story of Adam alayhi salam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam and then commanded the angels to prostrate, and Iblis, who was among the angels, he disobeyed the command of Allah. And the rest of the story, Allah tells us how, Adam was expelled and sent down to earth, and so on and so forth. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moves on the discussion to Bani Israel, and how Bani Israel, they were rebellious and always in a confrontation with their prophet, with Musa alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically tells us how whenever they were commanded with something, they would oppose and rebel. And the prime example that we have here is the story of the calf or the baqarah, when Allah commanded them to slaughter a baqarah. They started questioning, what kind of baqarah is it? What kind of calf or cow is it? And they went into so much questioning that, it basically put them off from doing what they were commanded to do. And so this is different than how we, the believers, should be. And so we should be, sami'na wa ata'na. we have heard and we have obeyed, we have submitted to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, you know, more stories or incidents that took place with Bani Israel and their prophet Musa alayhi salam. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moved on to tell us about Ibrahim alayhi salam. And this is what, you know, this juz or this para concludes with, the story of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam building the Kaaba. And so the two of them, father and son, built the Kaaba. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded this part of the Qur'an, this juz or this para of the Qur'an with. There are many lessons that we can derive from this juz or this para. First and foremost, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like He is the creator alone, He alone created everything, likewise, He alone deserves to be worshipped. And this is the concept of tawheed. And so this is the very basic message of the Qur'an. In every single surah of the Qur'an, you find the emphasis put on at-tawheed, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, just like He alone created everything and sustains everything, He alone deserves to be worshipped. Also, we have among the lessons here in this juz or this para, the characteristics of the hypocrites and how we should beware of them. They are among our ranks. They are among us believers, even today, you know, claiming to be with us, claiming to be believers, and yet in their hearts is nothing but kufr, disbelief, and animosity towards the believers, and hatred towards the believers, and plotting and planning with the kuffar against the believers. Among the lessons that we can also derive here, is, as we mentioned, Bani Israel, and how we believers should not be like the Jews who, rebelled against the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But rather, we should simply submit to whatever Allah has commanded us with, without questioning, without objecting. And finally, among the lessons that we can learn here is the fact that the Kaaba was built by Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam, this father-son relationship, which will be expounded upon in other surahs of the Qur'an. It was first mentioned here in the surah, in Surah Al-Baqarah. With that, we conclude this first session. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge and to grant us understanding of the Quran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.